This evening, we would like to share with you an experience, a long-lasting experience regarding human trafficking. In Turin, I came to know the world of the night and the world of the street, because I met some of the girls, in a special way, the first African lady that came in the office asking for help, crying aloud, "Sister, please, help me, help me." She woke me up, and that lady was called Maria. My first approach with Maria changed the whole of my life. She became my teacher. She became my catechist. She helped me to understand this terrible world. And from then on, I had to admit that my life has changed, no more in Africa, but all over the world, in order to try and to see what is happening really in the world. From this slide, you can really see the big phenomenon of trafficking in human beings. Because at the beginning I was annoyed when I used to see all these young girls on the streets. Because in Italy, when I came back from Africa, I used to see these young girls, mainly African, on the street. And I was annoyed with them. Because me too, like many people, I was convinced that they were there because they wanted to be there. But Maria helped me to understand that they were there because they were forced to be there. Because we had to deal with a new form of slavery. It is a huge problem, it's a huge phenomenon, and we have to be really aware of this. We can know that this is not happening only from poor countries, but the poor countries, they are taking these young people, young women, young mothers, young ladies, to go and work in other places. You have this problem even in New York. Maybe it is difficult in some countries to see the phenomenon, but we have to learn how to deal with it, how to recognize signs of this new slavery. We thought that slavery was over now 200 years ago, and we have to realize that this is a new form of slavery that is the most terrible slavery that human beings can really face. So it is present all over the world, because we are joined, we are uniting countries of origin, transit and destination. It is a global phenomenon that we are dealing with, and they are women and children for sale. You see, once in the past, many years ago, some years ago, we used to have countries going to poor countries to get their material, to get their products. Nowadays, we don't go to get their products or their material things. We go and take people. We go and take vulnerable young women, young children, that sometimes they are unaware of what is happening to them. And this is why we have to be aware, we have to know the problem, and we have to try to stop it. The sooner, the better. But unfortunately, after many years, just imagine, I started to work in 1993, and I'm still a square one. Square one, and now we keep on working, trying, but the traffickers are so well organized. And that's why we have also to be equally organized in order to stop this trafficking in human beings. What it is happening to these young people? How many are they? There are many. We count about 2.7 million every year of women and children. 80% women and children. Many, many of them are minors. There is a lot of money involved in it, $32 billion per year. It's a great lucrative amount of money that they have, that people will gain. And so now what are we doing? Who are these people? These people people are people who are risking, they are women and children risking their life. We have so many of them, they are misused, they are abused, they have to face maltreatment, even dying, being killed on the road. Some of them, they get diseases, HIV. 10-15% of them, they suffer because of HIV, AIDS. We have unwanted pregnancy. We have forced abortion. These are all the risks that these young people are facing. Not because they want it, because they are forced to it. And what it is really terrible, mainly for Nigerian women, they have to pay a lot of money. In order to regain their life, to regain their freedom, they have to pay nowadays not less than 80,000 euro. And in order to pay 80,000 euro, a young African girl has to undergo not less than 4,000 sexual encounters. And if they are going to finish to pay this amount of money, they are all finished. Morally, spiritually, physically, socially, they no longer know who they are because they lose everything, even their own identity, their own life, their own dreams, their own future. And that's why we are there to help them. How do we help them? How we help these young people to regain their trust, to regain back their life, their future, their desire to live and to be human beings again. That is how we need to become good Samaritans to them, ready to lean on them, to see them, to feel their suffering, and to try to tell them, be not afraid, I am here, I am with you. Now these young people, they want to live, they want to fly, they want to sing, they want to dance, they are young, but when they regain their life again, now we are so happy to help them to be like the birds, flying, going where God calls them to be, so that they continue to live as human beings. So now I really thank God and I thank all of you, so that may God help us to make our dreams, our desire to become true, so that we can really form a world without slavery, a world where every person can really be recognized as a human being, created in the image of God, and never called to be a slave. Thank you very much.